Hey everybody! I'm here today to talk to you about 8 things that people forget when taking a driving test. These are 8 things that people commonly forget about whenever they're taking their road test or their driving exam on the road for their full license. With that being said, let's get right into the video so hopefully you don't forget to do these things as well. Number one, people forget to check their blind spots. Most people will remember to check their mirrors before they remember to check their blind spots. And this is a bad habit to get into because enough experience drivers don't check their blind spots, let me tell you. So don't be one of them. Make it a habit to check your blind spots now before you do the road test, and hopefully you'll keep it as a habit for the rest of your driving career. Number two, they forget to bring their paperwork. In most cases and in most places, they're not going to allow you to take your driving test if you don't have the right paperwork. So make sure, what I recommend is that a couple of days before, you get all of your paperwork and you place them underneath or inside or on top or beside of a separate pair of shoes that you never wear. Except for the day of your road test, you're going to wear those shoes. Obviously, make sure that the shoes are comfortable and so forth. But let's say that old pair of sneakers that you haven't worn in like 6 months, place your paperwork with those shoes and wear those shoes on the day of the road test. They'll be waiting there for you, okay? Number three, most people forget to check their car. That's right. You got to make sure your car's working, all of your safety features, all of your signaling features, everything about the car's got to work properly. Check your car a couple days before and then check your car the morning of the driving test. I always recommend that people use their driving instructor's car for the driving test because the driving instructor will check it, and the driving instructor has a lot of spare bulbs probably in case the bulbs burn out. They're well equipped to handle any situation. But if you're using your own car, make sure that you check it. And if you're using your instructor's car, just ask them nicely, can you please check it and make sure that it works fine before we take the test? Number four, most people forget to put safety before smoothness. You see, everybody wants to make the smoothest right turns. Everybody wants to brake smoothly. But safety is number one. You are less likely to fail a test because of a lack of smoothness than a lack of safety. If you do something unsafe on the test, almost guaranteed you're gonna fail. If you do something that's not smooth on the test, but it is safe, you might lose points, but you might not even lose any points for it. It all depends on the situation. But you gotta put safety before smoothness. A lot of people actually forget to do that. A lot of people forget to, number five, let's preface that with the number. Number five, a lot of people forget to keep two hands on the steering wheel. So they'll put one hand on the steering wheel because this is how they're used to driving, you know, now that they're alone in the car, whatever you want to call it. I know they're with a driving test examiner, but they make it a habit to get one hand on the steering wheel. Get two hands on the wheel. Drive with two hands. You know, when you have your license, if you take one hand off for a moment to adjust the climate, excuse me, or to change the radio, or to take a sip of water or coffee or whatever, totally understandable. However, when you're taking your driving test, keep two hands on the wheel at all times, as much as you can, unless you gotta shift gears. That's a different story. Number six, a lot of people forget to use the parking brake. I use the parking brake every single time that I put the car in park. Very simple, every time. And I drive an automatic car. And when I drove a manual car, did the same thing, but it was even more necessary. Make it a habit to use the parking brake. It will save the parking pole, which is the thing that keeps your car parked and prevents it from rolling away. It'll save it and it'll lengthen the life of it. And it gives you a double safety to make sure your car doesn't roll away. So make sure you use the parking brake whenever you need to. Number seven, a lot of people forget to drive a safe speed instead of the flow of traffic. Let's say the speed limit is 50 kilometers an hour and it starts snowing. You should be slowing down to a slower speed. Maybe 30 kilometers an hour is maybe a good rule of thumb. But whatever the safe speed is, that's what you got to slow down to. However, traffic might be driving at 40, 45 kilometers an hour. That's dangerous. So a lot of people will drive with the flow of traffic, forgetting to drive the safe speed. Safety is number one on the driving test, and with day-to-day driving, forget about the flow of traffic. Drive at the safest possible speed. Okay, now if the speed limit is 50 and it's ideal road conditions, but the flow of traffic is 20 because there's a traffic jam, then drive at that 20 because that's the safe speed. But make sure you're driving at your safe speed above thinking about the flow of traffic, okay? Before thinking about the flow of traffic. Number eight, a lot of people forget to stay calm before, during, and after the test. You gotta calm those nerves. It's normal to be nervous and anxious, but you gotta calm them down. And that's because by staying calm, you actually give yourself a better chance of passing. If your nerves are going to hinder your ability to drive the car safely, that's when it's a problem. So by staying calm, you're going to give yourself a better chance at passing that test. And that's it. Those are 8 things that people forget to do or forget to think about or forget to understand when taking a driving test. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.